Let us solve the questions which involve the identities these a plus 1 by a whole square, a minus 1 by a whole square, a plus 1 by a into a minus 1 by a. Now, the first two questions does not involve these identities. We'll use them after this. Now, let us solve first question. It is 3 minus x into 3 plus x into 9 plus x square. Now, how do we solve this? Either we can do is multiply first bracket with second bracket and find the answer, and then multiply the answer with this bracket, right? That would be without using the identity. Now, we can also use it with using the identity. Which identity are we going to use? It is a minus b into a plus b equals to a square minus b square, right? Because we have two brackets which are being multiplied, one with a negative sign between them, other with a positive sign, plus both the terms are same, for a and b are present in both the brackets. Now, first let us use this identity into this. 3 minus x into 3 plus x. Now here a is 3 and b is x. So we can write this as a square, which is 3 square minus x second term square, which is x square, and the whole the answer is multiplied with third bracket, right? Now this is 3 square is 9 and minus x square is x square. Now we have this, right? Now if you look at both the terms, these are again changed into the formula which is present on LHS, that is left hand side, a minus b into a plus b. Here a is 9 and b is x square. Therefore, again using this identity, square of first term, that means 9 square minus square of second term, which is my second term, it is x square. So 9 square is 81 minus x square whole square. X square whole square, that means x square multiply by x square. You know x square multiply by x square is x power 4, because when we multiply two terms with the same base, that means their powers get added. 2 plus 2 is 4. So we have x power 4, right? Now the final answer is 81 minus x square. Let me repeat the solution for you. First we solved these two brackets using this identity, a square minus b square. Therefore we had square of first term minus square of second term, and then we multiplied with the third bracket, and we notice that this again gives us left hand side of this identity. So we can use further this formula. So we have first term square minus second term square. In this case, first term is 9 and second term is x square. So when we solve this, we get 9 square is 81 minus x square whole square is x ki power 4, right? Now let us see our second question, which is x minus 5 into 2x plus 3 into x plus 4. Now you see, can we use some identity to solve this question, which is x minus 5 into x 2x plus 3 multiply by x plus 4. Think, is there any identity we can use to solve this question? No, there is no identity, because neither we have a plus b whole square, neither we have a minus b whole square, nor do we have a plus b into a minus b. Therefore, how are we going to solve this without using identity? First we will multiply first two brackets, and thereon the product will be multiplied with third bracket, or you can multiply second and third bracket, or third and first bracket, it does not matter, right? First let us multiply x minus 5 with 2x plus 3, okay, and thereon we'll multiply x plus 4, or you can write it x plus 4 along with it, and you can drag it to the down and then we'll solve it. Okay, x minus 5 multiply with 2x plus 3. First term has to be multiplied with first term of second bracket. So we write it as x into 2x plus first term with the second term x into 3, right? Plus minus 5 into 2x. And then we have, I'll be writing over here, we have minus 5 into 3, right? Now x into 2x is 2x square, x into 3 is 3x, minus 5 into 2x is minus 10x, plus of minus 10x is minus 10x, and minus 5 into 3 is minus 15. So plus of minus 15 is minus 15. Now whole of this bracket is actually being multiplied with third bracket, which is x plus 4. Now you can write this as plus 3x minus 10x is minus 7x and minus 15. Now whole of the term is multiplied with this bracket. Now let us solve this term. 2x square, now we'll pick the first term from first bracket and multiply with second bracket. 2x square multiplied with first term of second bracket, which is x, plus 2x square multiply with second term of second bracket. Now then we have plus minus 7x, which is second term of first bracket, with first term of first bracket, and then again plus minus 7x into 4, right? Now plus third term of first bracket multiplied with second first term of second bracket, and third term of first bracket is multiplied with third term of second bracket, sorry, second term of second bracket, right? Now 2x square into x is 2x cube, 2x square into 4 is 8x square, plus minus 7x into x is minus 7x square. Plus of minus 7x square gives us minus 7x square. Now minus 7x into 4 is minus 28x. So plus of minus 28x is minus 28x. Minus 15 into x is minus 15x. Plus of minus 15x is minus 15x. Similarly, minus 15 into 4 is minus 60. Plus of minus 60 is minus 60. Now you can add the similar terms. For example, 8x square minus 7x square is x square. So I can write it as 2x cube minus x square. Now minus 28x minus 15x is minus 43x, right? Minus 60 is what is left, the last term. So this is my final answer. Let me highlight this, which is 2x cube minus x square minus 43x minus 60, right? So when we have this kind of question where you cannot use any identity, just simply solve it by first solving first two brackets or any of the brackets and then multiplying the product with the remaining bracket, right? So I hope you are clear with this question. Now let us see the third question. Now you have to identify that which kind of identity do we use, have to use in this question. For example, the question says that if x plus 1 by 3 is equal to 3, that means if the value of this is equal to 3, sorry, here it is x plus 1 by x. If x plus 1 by x equals to 3, find x square plus 1 by x square, and then we have to find x power 4 plus 1 by x power 4. Right, this is the information which is given to us, which is x plus 1 by x equals to 3, and this is the information which is missing and we have to find it out. Now see, is there any identity which connects both the given information and the missing information? Yes, we have this identity. Here a plus 1 by a or x plus 1 by x is the given information, and x square plus 1 by x square, this is my missing information. So let us use this identity to find the answer. If x plus 1 by x equals to 3, right, and I am using this identity, so let us square on both sides. That means we'll square in on this side as well as we square on this side. X plus 1 by x whole square equals to square of 3. 3 square is 9. So I write over here 9. Right? Now we are asked to find out x square plus 1 by x square. So let us open this bracket. Let us use this identity, which is square of first term, because it is actually a plus b whole square. So square of first term plus square of second term plus twice of a into b. A is x, b is 1 by x, a into b is 1 by 1. So we'll write 2 is equal to 9. So that means x square plus 1 by x square, when you take to the other 2 to the other side, it is 9 minus 2, right? It is actually equal to x square plus 1 by x square equals to 7, right? So the answer of my first part is 7. Now let us see, we are asked to find out x power 4 plus 1 by x power 4. Now is there any way I can take from x to power of 4? Yes, if we do it with the help of x square plus 1 by x square, because you know, if we square x square whole square, we'll get x power 5. So that means we have to square the term which involves x square, so that we can get something like this, x power 4 plus 1 by x power 4. Now you know that in the first part, what we found out was x square plus 1 by x square is equal to 7. Now if I again square on both the sides, because I need power 4. So when we'll square this kind of bracket, we'll have something which will involve x power 4. Let us try. Now squaring on both sides. Squaring on both sides of equal to sign. Now x square plus 1 by x square whole square. Here 7 square. Now x square plus 1 by x square, it is, consider this as a term and consider this as b term. A plus b whole square is square of first term plus square of second term, which is 1 by x square whole square, plus twice of first term, which is x square, into second term, which is 1 by x square. Now you can cancel this because it is present in both numerator and denominator, plus x square whole square. Like I told you, it's x power 4 plus 1 by x square whole square. It means 1 by x square into 1 by x square. Multiply the numerator, it's 1. X square into x square, it's x power 4. So I have x power 4, right? Now I have only 2 over here, right? Now we know the value is equal to 49, because we have squared on both the sides. So the value is equal to 49. Should have been written in the previous step. 7 square is 49. Now if you take 2 to the other side, we have x power 4 plus 1 by x power 4 equals to 49 minus 2 equals to 47. Right? So what we did was, first we found out which kind of identity would work to find this value, which is missing information, right? And then we saw how can we convert anything which is given to us for with x power 4. Then we realized that if we square this term, we'll have something which has power 4, and it actually matched to what we require, and thus we found out that the answer of second part is 47, right?